So my question is, so you've never been through rape. I've had family members and all that. So you have to understand that idea. The other thing is, I mean, some people, like she's saying, depending on where you are, you know, you can't go and get help. It's not like that for every...
That's actually not true. Abortion is never the only option. That is a myth.
I know, but you understand. If she can't... If she can't afford, if her mom cannot afford to get help, she can go to the hospital, but she's going to have all these bills. So she can't take care of herself because that takes a big toll on a woman's body.
Still doesn't answer the question.
And then the other thing is that y'all are out here, which I understand. I, you know, I respect y'all's view and all that, but you have family members and people coming through here that have been through this.
Yeah, of course.
That that's, you know, and you're hurting other people while being out here. Now, I understand y'all's point of view, but I don't think that it's appropriate to be out of school because you have younger children and kids driving by, families or kids, and they're seeing stuff like that.
So there's a lot that you put out on the table right here. So can you want me to unpack it a little bit for you? Okay, so the rape issue. We are against abortion for the same reason that we are against rape. It is the violent destruction of a smaller body by a larger one. Okay? So that's why we stand against it. Now, in our society today, what we do with rapists, because God's law isn't established, it's just humanistic law. What we do with rapists is we feed them, we clothe them in prison, we try to rehabilitate them according to worldly views, we pamper them, and then we set them free. I say execute the rapists, but don't punish the child for the sins of the father.
But now in the Bible, doesn't it say that it's not our place to judge somebody?
No, but actually,
I feel
no.
Like that's where y'all are coming.
It says
right
you
now.
Take the plank out of your own eye, you examine yourself, and then you judge. Julian, I appreciate you, brother.
I'll see you tomorrow.
It says actually the spiritual man judges all things of matters of good and evil. So it's not bad to not determine what's good and what's evil.
Will you be here tomorrow?
Absolutely.
Okay, I'm gonna get those other questions answered from you. But
yeah, and one last thing about the rape. I'm very passionate about this. Abortion covers up and provides an avenue for rapists to be able to actually perpetuate their crimes and get away with it. Look into that a little bit. That's a statement that I could unpack for about 15 minutes and I have the stats behind it. It is a disgusting thing. More women are raped because of abortion and then the rapists are pampered with the funds, the tax money of the victims themselves. The tax money of the victim herself goes to feed this barbaric animal in jail, and the baby is the one that's slaughtered. Now, if God's law is established, if righteousness is established, then the rapist gets executed and the baby. Now, obviously, that's a traumatic thing for a woman to go. I could never even imagine about that. But the solution isn't slaughtering the baby. The solution is slaughtering the animal that did it. And I never hear that argument. I never hear that from the other side. And it's and for me, it's like, there's no way I can take your worldview, not yours. I'm kind of lumping you in a group there, which is a logical fallacy in itself. But there's no way I can take secular humanism seriously when it's like, there's never any, I don't see the arguments for destroy the rapist. I see the arguments for destroy the baby.
Well, let me get the rest of this for you tomorrow.
Yeah.
I gotta get to class.
God bless you. What's your name?
Shelly
Joe. What's your name?
Levi. Sorry, I got a little pissed off.
Oh, hey, no. Hey, that's totally cool. Hey, I appreciate
you're
you.
You're trying to piss off people. You're doing it.
Yeah. Actually, it's agitation. The 18th century abolitionists, they the whole thing is to not be at peace with the sin that is going on.
Listen, I'm actually, I totally get that.
Yeah.
It's not obvious. Yeah. I don't totally agree with y'all.
Yeah, of course.
But I'm, I gotta get to class actually.
Hey, Levi, come back out tomorrow. So appreciate you.
Yeah. I meet you.
You rock. All right, thank you. Yeah.